in the closing months of the war between the states, ultimate victory has been reduced to a question of supply. Nowhere a shortage is felt more keenly than in the headquarters tent of a certain general of the Union armies.
Where's my laundry?
I'll send Parmenter for it immediately, sir.
Wilton Parmenter, Quartermaster Corps, member of a proud Philadelphia family with great military traditions. He, too, has found a place to serve. Private, in charge of officers' laundry.
And no starch!
Parmenter has come through with the underwear many times under fire. An awesome responsibility. But this time, fate takes a hand. An excess of pollen fills the air.
Get out!
You heard it, man! Charge!
And so within a matter of days, victory came to the Union forces. And Wilton Parmenter, Quartermaster Corps, became a man of destiny, the scourge of Appomattox. Members of the Parmenter family assembled to observe the ceremonies honoring Wilton Parmenter. Wilton's first cousin, Major Achilles Parmenter. His second cousin, Lieutenant Colonel Hercules Parmenter. His uncle, Colonel Jupiter Parmenter. And his father, General Thor X. Parmenter. Heroes all. In splendid tradition, they gathered here to pay honor to another member of the Parmenter family, Wilton Parmenter, the scourge of Appomattox. They watched proudly as he stepped forward to receive his just reward from a grateful country. Promotion to captain, the Medal of Honor, and the Purple Heart. He was the only soldier in history ever to get a medal for getting a medal.
Now, Parmenter, we've got to find an assignment befitting the scourge of Appomattox.
Sir, they've gone through three commanding officers at Fort Courage, two desertions and a nervous breakdown.
Fort Courage, eh? Good thinking, Wormsbecker. At a frontier post like that, he might be just the inspirational leader they need. Captain Parmenter, as of this moment, you are the commanding officer of F Troop.